last-minute decision to cancel the Commonwealth Games has dashed the hopes of hundreds of Aussie athletes who'd been working and looking forward to representing their country on home soil.
For more, Olympian Grant Hackett joins us now from Melbourne. Grant, thanks so much for your time. What was your initial reaction to the news?
Morning. Yeah, morning, Carl. Morning, Sarah. Disbelief and shock, actually. I thought it was a joke when I first heard the news that they're actually cancelling the Commonwealth Games. I mean, this is not the local bowls club cancelling a weekend meet. I mean, this is something of such a significant nature and so hard to get these sorts of events in your own country, and particularly small countries like Australia. When we host things like the Olympics or Commonwealth Games, it's a big deal. So to cancel it, you know, what feels like, I know it's 2026, last minute, was a real shock.
You're a very successful businessman now. When you look at the economics of it, it doesn't stack up, unfortunately, in the current climate. But I guess you take it back and you say, well, why did you decide that in the first place? And then you look at the figures for how much it was going to cost in the end. You don't know if they're true or not. So there's still a bit of uncertainty around it. But it is deflating.
Oh, absolutely. It's deflating for not just the athletes, but the entire country, and particularly the state of Victoria and Melbourne. But, yeah, talking about the figures, Carl, $6 to $7 billion when it originally was going to cost $2.6 billion. I mean, we're talking almost three times the original cost. I mean, who did the financial modelling around this to begin with? Because, you know, we're talking about break costs, that it's going to be $1 billion to break this event. But what about all the costs that went into the bid for the event in the first place? That's tens, if not hundreds of millions of dollars that are spent on that process as well. So, you know, we normally get a lot of economic benefit when we host these big events like the Grand Prix, like the Australian Open here in Melbourne. And obviously the Commonwealth Games is similar to those types of events. So what's the economic benefit we're also giving up by not hosting this event in 2026 also?
And Grant, we know, of course, Victoria is in ballooning debt at the moment, the worst in the country. So something had to give here. But what we don't know around that uncertainty continues is how much this will actually cost us just in terms of cancellation.
Yeah, and we all fully appreciate the significant debt that Victoria does have as a state, and certainly tough decisions do need to be made. We've seen taxes go up here in the state, of course, particularly on the back of COVID and the cost of that and the series of lockdowns that we had. But at the same time, why did we just go and cancel the event? Surely we could have revised the event, we could have scaled things down, we could have looked at bringing venues back into Melbourne where we've got such great sporting infrastructure. I mean, to the left of me, we've got Marvel Stadium, to the right of me, we've got the MCG, we've got the Melbourne Sports and Aquatic Centre around the corner here. We've got such great infrastructure in Melbourne. Why are we looking at, you know, scaling down the event but still hosting it, but doing it at a much less cost, rather than just saying, hey, the cost was too big, we're going to pull out now and we're going to deflate, you know, the entire state, nation and all the athletes that were really looking forward to competing in front of that home crowd.
For a minute, if Dan Andrews thought it would cost him the election in a couple of years' time, he wouldn't have done it. Clearly, he's read the mood of the public, right? I mean, the guy's a smart operator.
Oh, there's a reason he's been in power for so long, and he's obviously ridden a lot of ups and downs, and particularly through COVID, and his popularity has certainly stayed intact down here in Victoria. So reading the tea leaves as a politician, I mean, they're very good tactically and strategically at making sure that they align to the public's interest. But at the same time, I honestly think these sporting events, we can't underestimate the power of them. We saw, you know, when we held the Olympics in 2000, the inspiration that that brought to the nation. We saw here in 2006 in Melbourne just how good the Commonwealth Games were. And I think we're really going to miss out on 2026, unfortunately.
I agree. And part of that movement towards 2032, big international meets, a great thing psychologically for our young ones to get accustomed to.
Well, that's one of the biggest disappointments in all of this. Of course, the biggest sporting event in the world is the Olympic Games, and the lead-up meets are just as important because it gives you that opportunity to race all the international athletes. It also gives you an opportunity to race in front of a home crowd. For me as an athlete, I got to compete at three Olympic Games, but racing in front of everyone in Sydney and the extra pressure that comes with that, don't get me wrong, it is unbelievable to have that home support, but it's a different sort of pressure. So when you have an opportunity in all these lead-up international competitions to compete in front of a home crowd and you build up to 2032 where you really get on the world stage, the world's biggest sporting event, to miss out on that now is going to be costly to some extent to some of the athletes that will be competing in 2032 that don't now have that opportunity, and with all the uncertainty now around the Commonwealth Games itself.
Yeah, exactly.
Geez, you look good. Have you been drinking the water from the Yarra? Look amazing.
Doing the best I can, Carl. Doing the best I can. I mean, I'm trying to follow in your footsteps, of course.
So yes.
I've been looking at your diet and I've just been going... Yeah. Carl's doing something right. Don't you agree, Sarah?
I do agree, Carl. You're looking fantastic.
How lucky are you?
Looking fantastic. Oh, hello.
Ow.
Hello.
Thanks, big fella.
Thanks,
love your
Grant.
Work. Well, Dan Andrews has sent shockwaves across the country announcing Victoria will no longer be hosting the 2026 Commonwealth Games. Premier saying that the state would not be able to afford the potentially $7 billion prize tag.
To discuss, we're joined by Geelong Mayor Trent Sullivan and 10-time Commonwealth Games gold medalist Leisel Jones in Brisbane. Thank you both so much for your time. Trent, let's start with you. Now, the Victorian government initially predicted the Games would cost $2 billion. It seems whoever crunched those numbers was way off.
Oh, well, way off the mark. This has been incredible news by cost escalations from over $2 billion to nearly $7 billion. This was news to everybody. We're seeing shocked reactions in regional Victoria, all the hubs, the organising committee. We just cannot believe these numbers that have finally come out.
Mm. Neither can the cops. What's going on down there? Anything we should know about?
Geelong's a busy town.
Hey, just in relation to this decision, I mean, one of the great beneficiaries in the lead-up to the last election was going to be the flow-on effects for regional areas.
Yeah.
Geelong, what impact will the decision have on Geelong itself?
So one of the major things that's most exciting about the Games isn't just the sport on the field, it's the legacy outcomes to the community post the event itself. The investment in sporting infrastructure, in social services, in upgrades, everything that comes along with it. We definitely welcome the state government's announcement that they'll still be investing over $2 billion into the regions. However, we're yet to have confirmation as to what that will exactly look like. Our greatest concern in the regions is that this money is spent on the ground and our community does get this infrastructure by 2026, but we're waiting on the details.
A lot of people are waiting on a lot of details, it would seem, Mayor, and this is the issue, I guess. Of course, those regional communities still need that funding. Are you frustrated, though, that the government took so long to pull the plug on the Games and perhaps should never have entered them in the first place, instead promising to spend that money on infrastructure from the word go?
We all knew that when it was announced that a regional model of delivering the Games had never been done before and that there were going to be additional costs in this. That's why we were so excited when it came out that it would be for an affordable amount for $2.6 billion that the government did commit to. To now be so close out from the Games, it's only a short while, it's only less than 3 years, to have it reneged on that is incredibly heartbreaking. So our concern really is for infrastructure and for the community clubs, the people on the ground, the kids who need this access to infrastructure to help them play their sports. That is what the greatest concern is, and that's one of the most heartbreaking details about this.
Level with us, you don't think you'll get any of that cash?
Well, look, the way I'm seeing it is that there's money, they've committed spending to the regions. We have to have details on whether that will be directed exactly towards what the Commonwealth Games commitments were. There's money back on the table. Everybody wants a slice of the pie. Everybody wants infrastructure for their communities. And we feel like we're going to have a fight ahead of us to make sure that ours is delivered.
Leisel, I don't think there's a person in Australia who doesn't feel sorry for the athletes here. How much of an impact will it have on them?
It will have a huge impact, but it only won't have an impact on the athletes, but it's actually going to have an impact on small businesses in the area that were planning to have a Commonwealth Games in their area, which means that people from all around the world were going to be visiting their businesses, frequenting them, spending money, and that's probably the most disappointing part. And for someone like me, don't get me wrong, the athletes are so resilient. Wherever the Commonwealth Games will be held, they will turn up, they'll do a wonderful job, and they won't be fazed by something like this. But it's all the people on the peripheries that do get affected most by cancellation of a Commonwealth Games. So my heart really goes out to them. It also goes out to sports like netball, squash, lawn bowls, who don't get the opportunity to compete at an Olympic Games. And the Commonwealth Games is their opportunity to compete on the world stage, to get their sport out there. And I'm really disappointed for kids all around regional Victoria that now won't get the opportunity to see the stars in their hometown, to be inspired by the wonderful athletes, whether it's the Paralympians that get to compete as well. I think it's really disappointing to see that the little kids will be disappointed that they don't get the chance to see some really great athletes in their local area.
Leisel, I guess this decision has really thrown a lot of uncertainty around the 2026 Games full stop and whether or not they'll go ahead. Are you worried about that outcome?
I'm really worried, actually, because we're not many years out now from the Games happening. And the ability for someone to be able to pick it up. We had Anastasia Palaszczuk yesterday saying that it's going to be very challenging to turn it around. The Gold Coast has the opportunity. We've got all of the facilities and they did a wonderful job in putting on a Commonwealth Games. It was worldwide. It was just very well received. But it's really challenging to turn it around. So I am really worried about the Commonwealth Games in 2026 and what that's going to look like, because it is a really quick turnaround and I do worry about that.
Yeah, for sure. And look, I have such great memories of the Com Games in 82. You wouldn't have been alive then, either of you two. But Matilda coming out, the big paper mache kangaroo and all the kids filing out of it. Tracy, with Rob DiCostello winning the marathon. I could go on and on. I think
we love the Commonwealth Games. Yeah. They're amazing.
Yeah, I agree with you. It's a real shame. Anyway, well, Premier Daniel Andrews says it was an easy decision to cancel the Commonwealth Games. It was originally budgeted for $2.6 billion, but he says it blew out to six, perhaps even $7 billion.
Those figures are being slammed as inflated and grossly exaggerated. Birmingham's Games in 2022, by comparison, cost $1.5 billion. The Gold Coast, an estimated $2 billion. And Glasgow in 2014, just $1 billion.
Evan Lucas from Investsmart joins us now. Evan, good morning to you. Questions around how the budget blew out by that much. Do you buy it?
Yes and no. And why I say that and sort of sitting on the fence, apologies, Carls, is if you have five regional hubs that you have to provide five different infrastructure projects to, five different requirements around what areas are going to be redeveloped, then you can make that argument. I mean, the one thing I would say, though, is that, again, that's always going to be the question. That was what was put to him yesterday, was why go through five different individual sort of hubs rather than having one? And clearly, you know, you highlight what goes on with the Gold Coast. Geelong is the place to therefore look. Why was it not brought back to one hub? Or even as the, you know, the Com Games group is saying, why not bring it back to Melbourne and get it done for a price that everybody has seemed to be able to do it for the last 3 to 5 one of these events?
Yeah, and also I guess the assumption that perhaps it wouldn't have cost as much as they're saying it now costs. I mean, why can't the government afford it anymore?
Well, I mean, let's put it out there straight away. I mean, the Victorian scenario, looking out to 2027, will mean their net debt is the equivalent of having Queensland, New South Wales and Tasmania combined and a bit more. That is how much debt the state is currently holding. That is how much of a problem that that they are facing with regards to funding. And so I would say this very clearly. This won't be the last thing that he has to announce. That has to be clearly part of this. I mean, they've already shown that they've had to water down some of the tax recuperation they put in their budget. It was a couple of months back. Payroll tax for private and independent schools has been round back. So they have a massive debt bill problem, and that, therefore, is where this is not going to be the only project that has to go by the wayside.
So better from an economic point of view to cut and run, given that they're up the Yarra Creek.
Yeah, oh, I think the way to do it is that, again, they keep justifying these projects that for every dollar in, there's going to be about $1.10, $1.15 return. What's come out with some of the papers lately is that those projects a dollar in, is some of them are as bad as 51 cents return. So that is probably the argument to you, Carl. The economics of it is not just about the socio side of it, is that it just does not stack up. The costs, the requirements, the overall project benefit is just not there. And that is having to be the strong management that he wants to purvey. If he's doing that, therefore cancel projects that don't make economic sense anymore.
Yep. Well, it's probably not the only one, as you say, and probably why it's not gone down too badly in some parts of Victoria.
Yeah, I guess it's a revelation that you probably might have anticipated a year and a half ago.
Exactly. When you cross your arms, you mean business.